I'm providing you as little information as I can manage to get away with. Kind of the same game the lady with the nice voice plays with you when she waxes eloquent about the premium credit card you just qualified for, the one with all those nice benefits like cashbacks and frequent flyer miles, while conveniently forgetting to divulge information about its high annual fee and its Shylockian APR. However, since I'm taking the high road over the credit card sales lady here, I feel I do need to tell you a little bit more about the chapters to follow. In the course of the book, I shall try to establish certain theses. For example, Indian politicians are misunderstood selfless patriots. Indian wedding ceremonies keep down the divorce rate. Gunda, a movie made in 1998, was the greatest celluloid creation of Bollywood. Exactly. Clap, please. The heart of India lies in the embodiments of subaltern culture, namely Bhojpuri songs and Mithunda flicks. There are some underlying principles behind the success of Hindi mega soaps and Indian reality shows, principles even mortals can understand. You can start your own management institute. Hindi movies taught me how to lead my life. Now I really have to stop, because if I say any more right here, this introduction chapter would have lost its focus, which I've been told is bad writing. A word, actually a bit more than that, about the style. This book is not a work of fact, nor is it a work of fiction. If you're looking for a single story, there is none. Instead, there are a number of fairly independent chapters, with the only unifying theme running through them being the vehicle of narration, is humor and sarcasm. Throughout the book and throughout my life, I have had no intention of offending anyone. If I have unknowingly done so, I apologize wholeheartedly. Please consider it as a joke that went too far. Kindly excuse. Even after that, if you do feel the urge to burn this book, kindly do it under expert supervision. Please also try not to make a flaming mess on the streets. If you decide on other forms of protest, like sending me colored underwear, kindly do have the courtesy to inform me beforehand so that we may both be present and share the media coverage. In passing, I do have a regret. Coming from the world of blogging, which is an activity critically dependent on interactive user participation through feedback and comments, a book is somewhat restrictive, a one-way street with one person doing the talking and the other doing all the listening, an experience somewhat like having a conversation with my mother. This brings me to the problem. I do not know who you are. Are you one of those poor souls who have actually paid money for this book? If you are, was it to read or to give your 7-month-old something to tear and play around with so that he, she does not damage something actually valuable? Or are you a friend, relative who has been emotionally blackmailed to leaf through the pages? Or did you get this book as a gift from a friend you didn't particularly like and are thinking of that distant cousin who you in turn can give this book to? I wish I knew. I also wish for something else, and that is reader feedback. Of course, there is some feedback you get from your publisher, like no one's buying your book. That's valuable. There are other sources of feedback too, like buying samosas and discovering them wrapped in the pages of the book you wrote. That's even more valuable. However, what I'm most interested in is what you, the reader, think about the issues covered in the book. That is why I'm providing my email, is mayihelp@gmail.com, and the address of my blog, which is greatbomb.net, so as to actively solicit your opinion. Okay, that is enough of prevaricating. On to the main course. So this was the introduction.
Just to repeat that, that's mayihelp, not H-A-B, right?
Yes.
Yeah. And there's a question that's been nagging at me ever since Raghuta spoke, you know, which is, what was the different book that he wanted you to write?
So he wanted me to write a book which was a biography of Mithun Chakraborty. Now, here was the fun. I would love to write a biography of Mithun Chakraborty, but in order for me to do that, it's impossible to sit in the US and write something about Mithunda, because you really need to go to Ooty, you need to have like 3 days with Kanti Shah, and in order to understand, you know, I mean, there are two parts of Mithunda. One is the national, and that's why I find him to be unique. He's almost represents modern India in the sense he's totally schizophrenic. There's this national award-winning side where he does Mrigaya and the Adar Katha, which is amazing. And then there's this other side of him which does these Ooty cheapos. And he's only the only person who manages to kind of straddle both these worlds effortlessly. He can switch from one to another. And so if I was to write a biography on him, it would be easy to get the Mrigaya kind of... The Mrigaya part of it would be easy to get. But this other part of him is what I would be really interested in. For that I would need to be